Oh, hello, great readers. I'm Bill Chen.
I'm Nimakum.
I'm Ben Chan.
In this class, I'll read all of your part of The Lead of Homer.
Ass.
Oh.
The Lead of Homer. Theodora Wallbuckley. Job. 16th Secretary. A nurse with gall. And knowing how to yield. Whose rage defrauds us of so faint a field. If that our fury must forever burn. What make we here? Return. Ye chiefs. Such were your words and oh. Warriors. Crave no more. Lo there the Trojans. They threw swords in gore. This day shall give you all your soul's amends. Battle your hearts. This while he roused the fire in every breast. Close and more close the listening cohorts pressed. Angst wedged in ranks. Still grows. And spreads. And thickens round the king. As when a circling wall the builder forms. A strength defensive against wind and storms. Compacted stones the thickening work compose. And round him where the rising structure grows. So helm to helm. And crest to crest they throw him. Shield edged and shield. And man drove man on. They. And distinguished plumes. Together joined. Float in one sea. And wave before the wind. Follow the rest in glittering pomp appear. Their bold autumn din. Patroclus here. Brothers in arms. With equal fury fired. Two friends. Two bodies with one soul inspired, but mindful of the gods. To the rich coffer in his shady tent, there lay on heaps his various garments rolled, and costly furs, and carpets stiff with gold. From then seat Cabal, authentic frame, which never man had stained with ruddy wine. Nor raised in offerings to the power divine. But Peleus' son had raised in offerings, but to Jove alone. This tinged with sulphur, sacred first of flame, he purged and washed it in the running stream, then cleansed his hands, his eyes on heaven, of sacrifice. Forth in the midst, and thus the god implored, O thou supreme, high throned all height above, O great pelastic, that an angel, whom is surrounding for us, and vaporous chill, presidst on bleak dot on his vocal hill, whose groves the silly, resoster, surround, their feet unwashed, their slumbers on the ground, who hear, from rustling oaks, thy dark decrees, and catch the fates, ere, as of old, thou goest, at thy's prayer, glory to me. And to the Greeks despair. Lo, the best, the dearest of my friends, I yield, though still determined, to my ships confined. Hydrocus squam, I stay but half behind. Oh, These guard thy providential care. Confirm his heart and string his arm to war. His fame in arms not owing all to me. But when the fleets are safe from foes and fire, let him with conquest and renown retire. Preserve his arms, preserve his social train. Creative consents to half the chief's request, but heaven's eternal doom denies the rest. To free the fleet was grounded to his prayer, his safe return. The winds dispersed in air. Back to his tent the stern Achilles flies, and waits the combat with impatient eyes. Meanwhile the troops beneath Patroclus' care invade the Trojans and commence the war. As wasps, provoked by children in their play, pour from their mansions by the broad highway. In swarms the gutless traveller engage, what all their stings, and call forth all their rage. All rise in arms, and then, with a general cry, set their racks and domes, and buzzing progeny. This from the tents the fervent legion swarms, so loud their clamours, and so keen their arms. Their rising rage Patroclus' breath inspires, who thus inflames them with heroic fires. O warriors, partners of Achilles' praise, be mindful of your deeds in ancient days. You, godlike master, let your acts proclaim, and add new glories to his mighty name. Think your Achilles sees you fight. Be brave. Cheerful they heard, and kindling as he spoke, flew to the fleet, involved in fire and smoke. From shore to shore the doubling shouts resound, the hollow ships return a deeper sound. The war stood still, and all around them gazed, when great Achilles' shining armor blazed. Troy saw, and thought the dread Achilles nigh. At once they see, they tremble, and they fly. Then first thy spear, divine Patroclus, flew, where the war raged, and where the tumult grew. On both sports celestial shore, the grey pinion, bold Pyrrhotim stood. His shoulder blade receives the fatal wound. The groaning warrior pants upon the ground. His troops that see their country's glory slain fly diverse, scattered o'er the distant plain. Patroclus' arm forbids the spreading fires, and from the half-branch of pride Troy retires. Clear from the smoke the joyful navy lies, in heaps on heaps the foe tumultuous flies. Triumphant Greece her rescued Dix ascends, and loud acclaim the starry region reigns. So went thick clouds and ripped the mountain's head, o'er heaven's expanse like one black ceiling spread. Sudden the thunderer, with a flashing ray, bursts through the darkness, and lets down the day. The hills shine out, the rocks in prospect rise, and streams, and vales, and forests strike the eyes. The smiling scene wide opens to the sight, and all the measured ether flames with light. But Troy repulsed, and scattered o'er the plains, forest from the navy, yet the fight maintains. Now every Greek some hostile hero slew, but still the foremost, bold Patroclus flew. As Zorilucus had turned him round, sharp in his thigh he felt the piercing wound. The brazen pointed spear, with vigour thrown, the thigh transfixed, and broke the brittle bone. Headlong he fell. Next, those was thy chance, thy breast, unarmed, received the Spartan lance, his blow prevented, and transpierced his thigh. To be continued.